Hey everyone, welcome to another stream. Let me change my settings so everything goes according plan. I've downloaded Protostar, so let me check. Yeah, I can sign in. I believe it is the user. Got the password. Oh, okay. User. User. Okay. Star. I hope you guys can see it. Okay, so we can yeah, so here you have all the exercises that you need. So if you go to zero. So let's just start with the first level. This level introduced the concept that memory can be accessed outside of its allocated region. How the stack variables are laid out and that modifying outside the allocated memory can modify program execution. Okay, is GDB. Yeah, okay. So we have no idea why it is. Why does this me see. Yeah, I'm trying to get oh, yeah. So we have GDB, so let's just start with the first one. Stack zero. So let me get stack zero. Thank you for following me, Toto. And now my entire system is oh Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Okay, this sucks. Need to restart. Yeah, I've downloaded Protostar, so it's this one. You can download the ISO file from their website, and they have a lot of challenges that you can solve that is based on, yeah, buffer overflows. Pwn challenge. So, yeah, I have never used it before, so no idea if it is useful or yeah, what I can expect. But GVQ stack zero run. Okay. Test, what does, oh, try again. Okay. Sucks that I have this small screen, but Which functions do I have? This. Type or return, okay, Q. Okay, this is simple main, what can we see? Okay. Ah, we have put. Okay, what if we send, for example, a lot of A's? Does it crash? Create. Let's start with 800. Quit. It's Python. Okay. Python. Okay. And three. Okay. Yeah, I need to. You could use Python to do for simple. Let me check. Okay, we can do it that way. Import OS. Okay, we can do, for example, OS. System payload input text. I can do this. Really annoying if you are on a different system without anything at all. Okay, I need to open my cherry tree again. Because there it is. Let me check exploit development. Yeah, okay, here I have it. Hope I can find it inside. My notes. Yeah, okay, here I have it. Three. mode. Goddammit. Sudo su. God mode. Oh my god. Okay, say user. Okay. Okay, now let me try it here. Okay, so if you do opt, bin protostar. It really sucks that this is a damn old machine. Half or my comments doesn't work. I can also just use my other machine because this is really sucking. This just doesn't work. Sucks as hell. Okay, say the exploit development. Yeah, okay. Let me check. I have the source code, so make that protostar. Say the protostar. Stack 01. Stack. Okay, so GDB Q F run hello, try again. Okay, so this is much better than what we had at the first time. It was just annoying, the old shell, but now we can do a lot more. Yeah, this looks much better, but there are a lot of functions in this FFL. Can we find something interesting perhaps? Well, we have main. By the way, before I do this, check sec fail f to check if there are any protections on the fail, if it does even work. Oh, okay, yeah. Py enabled, partial rel row. But further, everything is disabled, so that's great. What we also can do is ltsf push try again, try harder, test. Okay, now let me just start and see how far we get. Let me first pattern create 1000. Okay. You can input this pattern and see if it perhaps crash. Just basic. Yeah, okay, segmentation fault. Yeah, okay, we have a segmentation fault indeed. Yeah, here, segmentation fault. Okay, So the next thing what we're going to do is calculate the offset. So we can use pattern offset, I believe it is this. Pattern offset value. Okay, normally it should give me the value. So it is definitely an stack-based buffer flow. Probably basic one. If we can find how much offsets we need. If there are any questions, yeah, you can just ask them, but I'm no expert yet, so yeah, can't answer everything. In main. What if I, for example, remove this? Not found in pattern buffer. How do you mean in pattern buffer? It's not found in the buffer, but stop it in reason 6F, pattern offset. What if I do? That's weird. It's weird because it should give me genetic search of write cyclic pattern to memory. Is extended instruction point REP, where's that REP points to this value, so Python, okay, print care 500. Okay, let me just run it. Okay, F. Yeah, okay, so it's it's the same memory address, so it's definitely no rotation in the addresses. But I need to calculate the offset. So yeah, we definitely can, for example, do this to check the ASP. Error, can't access memory yet. Okay, we cannot access the memory. Which makes sense because yeah, we have we should be able to calculate this offset, but pattern offset. Linux X basic. Okay, this is we can do info registers. Okay, so we can see that REP points to this address. But what about the RSP, the top of the stack? Okay, let me do X V 4 V 4 E cannot access memory at address. Checking my notes, what I'm doing. So it says the pattern offset. How can it find the pattern offset? Okay. So we have created a long pattern. It's the pattern create comments and then 500. So it creates a weird pattern. Okay. Yeah, it crashed. So we can then should be able to calculate the offset. Yeah. So next step. Now I need to check the RSP, yeah, the top pointer of the stack. Okay, this then is that info registers. And dan is het x de ERIP, this one. Okay, what if I do ASP, because that's the top of the stack. Ah, okay, yeah, so you can see the pattern string at here. Is this the top of the stack, okay. Of REP, so we will calculate this address at REP of the instruction pointer. For example, pattern offset REP of RSS REP. Yeah, it should be. What about the RSP? This one, no. Both aren't working as expected. Pattern offset value of RBP. Oh wait, RBP. God damn it. Ah, okay, yeah, okay. We found an offset 80, okay, but this is definitely not the correct offset. As RBP is just a base pointer that points to the stack. So we need to add 8 bytes. So, okay, let's try that. Oh, wait. Hungary documents exploit. Protostar sudo nano. Oh, wait. Sudo nano. Zero stack exploit.py. Okay, so the buffer is equal to times 80, right? But the problem is that this is definitely not the one to get the instruction pointer. The problem is that we need to add 8 bytes more. And now we should be possible to override the instruction pointer. Filler is C, so 8 bytes, for example. Buffer plus AEP plus filler. Okay. Now this should work. Let me quit and let me run it again. Well, at least we have indeed our A's in the RBP. But yeah, the problem is that this one has still not been overwritten by our A's, and that's our target. So, okay, something definitely is not So, what we can try to do is decrease the amount of C, because that can be the problem. So, So let me try six times here. And still no RIP has been overwritten. Which should be the case. Let me check. Let's try to reduce the amount of C back to 6. Yeah. Run the Python command again, okay, but this, okay, return, run the binary at insert new, this time we indeed, yeah. Okay, so we, the problem is probably the, the C part at this moment. Because we have indeed, okay, let me for example put a weird random number, no idea if this will work, but okay. Oh shit. Well, it seems that we can easily override the base pointer. We need the instruction pointer, not the base pointer. Well, we have our C's here. If anyone who's watching knows it, then yeah, go ahead and yeah, okay, we have an offset of 80 bytes. Well, at least we found an offset of 80 bytes. No idea where it was. Oh, it was here. Yeah, here. Found it 80 bytes. But we need to add 8 because we need to go to the instruction pointer. Yeah, we need to go one address above the base pointer. Then we should go to the instruction pointer. And this is what I see here, but oh wait, god damn it. I think I don't read. I was thinking to yeah, you should definitely I have no idea why. Yeah, but it shouldn't work because the offset is 80, but that is the base pointer. So we should go one address up. So then we add 8 bytes because it is 64, so 8 bytes. And yeah, we should go in the instruction pointer, but it's definitely here. Look, what is, why is my, go away. Thank you. So the idea is that you have a stack and yeah, we want to go to the instruction pointer. So we have the top of the stack, the bottom of the stack, and so yeah, let's say the instruction pointer that is targeting to this one. So this is the instruction pointer. Yeah, okay, so but we have actually the base pointer, and the base pointer, that's just yeah, some address that is pointing to the stack. So for example, we have the base pointer that is somewhere here and it points to the stack, so just somewhere on the stack. So we need to add 8 bytes in order for us to go to, yeah, to the instruction pointer, to this one. And that's what I'm trying to achieve at this moment, but no idea, yeah, how. Because, yeah, it should be 8, but I can't. No, it should be 6 bytes, but what if it's, for example, this is 6 bytes. Oh, shit. Run. Well, at least we have, yeah. Yeah, you can definitely see that if we decrease it, we have our bees at the base pointer. But now we need to get it to the instruction pointer, not the base pointer. Oh my god. So, okay, dus we have. So the problem is, I need to add 8 to this perhaps. Let me check it right here. Let me check. Is this the new payload? I definitely need to run it again. Run. No, again we have 8. This is really weird. Run input welcome. WWC, let's try to reduce the amount of C back to 6. But system C is 8. If I decrease this by 8, increase this, then we have. Why is not the. Yeah, this is the top of the stack. Okay, so I think we have indeed the bees. So we need to run. Okay, now we have indeed. X, W, 8, W, AP, HP, cannot access memory, why not? Yeah, okay, so that's definitely our address that we are trying to target. Stack point 0. I definitely know that I'm probably making some really stupid mistake. Well, 64 is the. Oh, I should have definitely checked the code. Oh, really? Oh my god. Should have definitely checked the code next time because it is probably easier than I was expecting. Just fear and sick this one. And then probably run. Yeah, this. Oh my god, George. You have changed the modified variable. Yeah, I probably have the. No registers. I have changed the variable. But the problem is that we need to change, the code that we are going to send. So what we need to do, if we check the code, can I get the code again? Yeah. You can see it here. Obviously, stack one. Yeah, this is stack one. This was stack zero. That's what we have done. So this is level one. But level two is we need to change it to this variable. So what we can try to do is this hard coding in our exploit. And the problem is that this is little endian. And as you all know, little endian, I hope, we need to reverse order to put it in reverse order. So we start with 64, 63, 62, 61, and that's it. Let me also send the bytes variant. Okay, let me compile this second challenge because that's the sudo nano f of. Nee. Let me check. Can I still GCC FNO stack protector C execute stack format? Oh nee, zero stack output F2. Okay. So what we're going to do is we quit this. We run our Python script. That was it. Okay. We placing this. We do GDB QF2 run. Okay, fuck. Twee, die specifieke argument. Try again, you got nog no nul. Die specifieke argument, else you trim. Okay, let me. Okay, GDB QF2. Input run input context please specify an argument. We need to give it an argument. Yeah, so. Oh shit, verkeerde. Sixty-four. This can be gone. This can be gone. X64, x63. This is 61. Let me just remove the B press. This is the problem. Okay, and then we print it again. Please specify an argument. Get input.text. Okay, wait. It should be much easier. You need to do it this way, because Python, of the dollar sign, specifies that we can give an argument. We can input, we can give input. So now it's just x64, x63, x62, x61. And then this should work. Or not. Oh wait, I forgot the... Where? Wait, what? Missing a pattern called print. Did you mean print? Probably need to specify Python 2. Yeah, but it should work because I have the value that it wants 64 times as the buffer is 64. So I am filling the buffer with A's and then sending this number. But if we're gonna go to variable to with the dollar symbol, you will be able to give your input in the command line as an argument. Yeah. Something goes wrong. A multiplied by 64 plus. Yeah. Why is it going wrong? Should definitely I'm sending 64 times A. So if you go back to the code, if I can pick up the page, this is really. You can see the char buffer has a buffer of 64. So if I send 65 characters, then of course that 65th character will be overflowed. This is not in the buffer. So I'm sending 64 times the A character to fill it. And then the modified character must be equal to this. And because it is little endian, I need to do it reverse order. So start with 64 instead of 61. Exactly what I'm doing. But somehow it says you got no x, no. So where is the mistake? Where is the mistake? If anyone can explain me, I am all open. Probably some stupid little thing. You've correctly got the variable right. Try again, you got. If I send this, then it should. Try again. What's happening if I gdb q we run try again, you got. Well, at least we have put. No registers. Amazing. Just weird. Here, D, C, B, A. A, B, yeah, A, B, C, D. Yeah. Yeah, I'm confused. Well, should. Okay, it's been Python, print of 560. Oh, I think stick. Yeah. I'm just checking some blog or article from someone who did this challenge. And yeah, he did the same thing. But for him, it worked. Here, you can see it right here. He did also, yeah, the same as me. Sending 64 times A, then the string that it is expecting me to change. Because yeah, the symbol. I am able to give input, and yeah, it works for him, but yeah, no idea what is different between me and him. No, it's really 64. Byte or so, we need to add byte to it. Oh, also no bytes. Perhaps this byte, nope. Yeah, we can use bone tools, of course. But let me try one more thing before I go. Then I'm leaving it for next week. But need to find. Okay, so we have. Bone import all, okay. R is, I believe it is local. F2, I believe. Okay, and then we are... I definitely get more used to bone tools. It's belief interactive it was. Okay, you have the list. Okay, file name local is not defined. And it's not local, it is. Bontus load local. Yeah, I need to get a local file. Dat van het remote. Ah, oké, dat was het inderdaad. Ja, yeah, oké. Please specify an argument. End of line. Oké, please specify an argument. So we are still sending. Yeah, send line is it. Send line indeed. Send line, receive line. Yeah, it must be interactive. But the problem is, how can I send? Well, I think this is definitely a sign for me to play more. Code and brackets mix it. No, that's just my weird shell. I don't know why it is behaving this weird, but you can see it just are double quotes, but somehow it's acting really weird if I check it here in Nano. No idea why, and don't tell me to use V or Vim, because the same thing happens there too. But okay, yeah, send interactive. Yeah, I need. Oh, you don't need to say. Sorry. Just something weird from my shell that I need to fix. Yeah, you can interact, so you can air.send. I want to, it is interactive because I need to send it, but somehow it's not I think I'm going to leave it for next time, but at least we solved the first challenge. If you remember the first challenge, 0001. So this is 01. It's just sending something. Now you can do the same actually. You can put Python print a keer 65. Okay, nou ja, exit. GDBQF run input context. And now it certainly doesn't work. Amazing. It's really amazing sometimes. List. I can try. Sixty-four because it has a buffer of 64. And we need to add B. Now let's do Python 2. I'm better with Python 2. Sixty-four plus B. Okay. Now nothing seems to work. That's the amazing world of Expo development. Something works and suddenly it doesn't work. You need to love it. Yeah, I'm sending 64 times A and 1B. No, it should definitely be 64, but okay, nah, yeah. Amazing. Well, yeah, we had it the first time, but yeah, this was the session of today. So if there are any questions, then you can ask them now if you want, or keep them for later. I don't see any questions, so yeah. Yeah, I want to thank you all for watching, and for joining this week's session, and I hope I see you all next week. And yeah, I wish you all a great evening, morning, or afternoon, and take care. So, see you all next week.